Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia strongly believes poll automation provider Smartmatic may be behind the bribery allegations against him. Saguet Party List Representative Rodante Marcoleta previously claimed money was transferred to two offshore bank accounts allegedly owned by Garcia. The poll chief denies owning those accounts. Garcia also claims a foreign company that has links to Smartmatic was the one that sent the money.
I'm not accusing anyone. I did not name but they forgot to erase the one who sent the $100, the one who manipulated everything to make it up that as if I have an account in in New York.
Hey, no.
Cayman. Nakalagay ma'am doon sa taas, Jaleo Consulting LLC. Jaleo Consulting LLC is actually a foreign company based in the United States, Miami, Florida. It's actually being operated and owned by a certain Jose A. Herrera, a foreigner. It so happened that when you inquired into a Jose A. Herrera exact name, he is actually an attorney at law and also is a director of Albatross Technologies Corporation. And it so happened that Albatross has an address in number 26 Pine Road, Pine Street in another country.
Yeah.
Barbados. Why is it that the address of this Albatross Technology is the same as the address of our former provider? Exactly the same.
Smartmatic?
Yes, ma'am. And when you look at the organizational chart, which was available online, it would appear that Albatross Technologies is just under the former provider. So I just want an answer.
Meanwhile, Garcia also claims Smartmatic illegally made money under the leadership of former COMELEC chairperson Andy Bautista. Bautista was indicted by a U.S. federal grand jury last week for allegedly taking bribes from Smartmatic.
Now, the allegation of a 700 million pesos alleged tax fraud, meaning to say supposedly earned by the government, supposedly for the government, for the commission, and yet given to the winning company at that time. Ang tanong na gusto naming masagot, why was the 700 million supposedly income na ng COMELEC yun, ng government, 700 million, kasi tax exempt, binigay natin ng COMELEC sa winning bidder.
Binigay sa Smartmatic. Let's be specific.
Ma'am. There was this conversation, according to the DOJ in WhatsApp, of the person's charge, which says that they are going to earn more than what they expected because of the tax. And so we made the research on that.
Several groups in the city of Pasig protesting the planned construction of a new city hall worth 9.6 billion pesos. Our very own Katrina Domingo on the line now with details. Kat, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. A surprising turn of events just occurred in Pasig City this morning. Pasig City Mayor Vico Soto went down the city hall to meet with those protesters who were rallying against his administration's plan to construct a new city hall worth 6 billion pesos. He planned to have a dialogue with them, but instead found out that these protesters were not actually residents of Pasig City, but were instead residents of Quezon City. The protesters themselves admitted to that when the Pasig mayor asked, who among you in Filipino, of course, who among you are from Quezon City? And gladly they raised their hands and even screamed, woohoo. The mayor was quite surprised and he said, and he explained to these protesters that he doesn't mind being questioned about his project and that his administration is in fact very open to explaining the details of this new Pasig City Hall, especially because it involves billions in taxpayers' money. The Pasig City Mayor Vico Soto said these protesters were probably paid by St. Gerard Construction Company. That is a company that is based in Pasig City. And our sources on the ground tell us that one of St. Gerard's owners may probably file a certificate of candidacy for mayor in October, but we have yet to confirm that. We have reached out to the owner of St. Gerard Construction as well as to the company itself, but they have yet to respond to our messages. But what is clear right now, Carmina, is that a group already filed a complaint before the Office of the Ombudsman against Soto and his administration, questioning why the city has to spend about billion pesos or about just for this new city hall project. Carmina.
All right, Kat, just a clarification there. I have the figure here at 9.6 billion, but I heard you say 6 billion. So which right. one is it?
Right. Good to clarify that, Carmina. The 6 billion pesos accounts for only the city hall, the city hall itself, the structure. But the figure rose to 9 billion pesos because the group that filed the case included the amount needed for an IT system infrastructure that they claim would be included in that project. But Carmina, technically, those two are separate in terms of bidding, in terms of actual bidding of the project.
Carmina. So the total cost that we're looking at here is 9 billion and not 9.6.
No, Carmina. For the structure itself, it's 6 billion, but the group is also raising about 3.6 billion pesos or about that number with regard to the IT infrastructure that will be included once the city hall is already built.
Okay,
Carmina.
Got it. Now, after the mayor talked to this residents from Quezon City, what happened then?
They basically dispersed, Carmina. We have got pictures of the residents actually boarding down or alighting from a bus. They are wearing a white shirt, and we even tried to ask them ourselves. One protester said that they were just told that they were going to Pasig City and she just came along because she wanted to meet Mayor Vico Soto. She thought that it was actually a field trip to Pasig City to show and express her support for Mayor Vico, while another protester who was holding this tarpaulin that reads something like no to the 6 billion peso City Hall project or something of that sort, he actually told us that he was just scouted from Barangay Holy Spirit in Quezon City and that he was not told about the issue that they will rally about during that event. Carmina.
All right. Thanks a lot. Katrina Domingo there joining us on the line. A suspect in the murder of radio broadcaster Percy Lapid dies in a suicide. Orly Mendoza shot himself after holding his partner and child hostage when police tried to arrest him. The suspect is said to have accompanied gunman Joel Escorial, make that Escorial, when he killed Lapid in October of 2022. The alleged mastermind, former Bureau of Corrections Chief Gerald Bantag, remains at large.